Hello all, welcome back to Battle Brothers in the Community Challenge Let's Play. I'm Jaames Johnson, aka Sulfurblade, and yeah, this is I think gonna be like episode 14. So there is that. We still don't have a completely full group. We just recently patched up Turtle, I believe. And so now we need to basically chill out here at Dinglesmart. Well, Turtle gets himself better. Then we'll probably have to go green skin hunting. Alright, so the main wound is done now, he's just okay. And the monk to the rescue. All right. Turtle is covered enough that we can think about moving on here. Few orc berserkers. I don't have any archers. Oh well. Let's see how this goes. Thank you. Right, that fight went well. Went well. I gotta start remembering that Abel is able to use his crossbow and stuff. And start using that damn thing. Is Abel supposed to have hair, cover, quick hands, gifted, close back, berserker, nimble, and frenzy. we're off to kill a goblin camp. Am I there yet? Bean gangers are not that difficult. Necromancer would be the biggest problem mixed in with the fallen hero and the guys. I don't know as if I'm there yet.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
remember that army is on the road in case what I run into is, well, tough, but I don't expect it will be. There's an orc warrior. Slightly concerning. I should be able to take on a singular orc warrior without too much problem right now. I don't want to share the XP with anyone. Oops, pressed the wrong button. Oh well, lost a little XP. Alright, so this seems like a good place to put a cut in the episode. So this has been another episode of the Battle Brothers Community Challenge. A Let's Play series based off of using other people's builds. It started off pretty rough, but now I think things are starting to get under control. Though I'm not exactly using these builds probably the way they're supposed to be, like, Turtle the Forest tank, so, you know, he's supposed to have a spear. Kill 'em All Cleaver is supposed to be a duelist cleaver type person, and I have a shield on him, so... But I haven't picked up the duelist skill yet. I think once I get the duelist skill, I'll probably try to take the shield off of him and see what happens. Then we have the Ozymandias twins, which I think this one's turning out better than the other one. They're supposed to be fencers, not spearmen. And again, fencers that are duelists. I don't see me handing the fencing sword over to them until they get duelist. So they're going to be spearmen for a while yet. Unlucky noob dagger tank is, well, he stabs things with a dagger, so... But the only thing I haven't done correctly with this guy is he's supposed to have higher melee skill. And then you go stabby, stabby, stabby with the... with the puncture instead of the stab. But because I'm asthmatic, that's the other thing with this guy. I don't go stabby, stabby, stabby with the puncture. So, but he's been okay. I mean, he's not horrible. He stays alive and he controls an area of the field and keeps the pikemen safe. We already talked about the Ozymandias twins. Sujak the Fifth, which I don't know if he's going to be capable of being a Sujak, is supposed to end up a two-handed hammer guy. We'll see how that happens, but it's possible he might work out. And then Crimson Edge has been a star. Hard to screw this build up. Anyway, that's another episode of the Battle Brothers Community Challenge in the books. Hopefully you're enjoying the content. If so, leave a like and subscribe. And until next time, all, peace.